Another day does not pass by without us hearing yet another cybersecurity or privacy incident on the news. You may have heard about the Google Calendar scam, where scammers insert suspicious links into people's schedules, tricking them into clicking on that link and opening the Pandora's box. Who knows what cyber threats lurk at the end of that URL? It's even scarier when we hear about organizations like government institutions that we trust our most sensitive data with are also frequently under attack. You may remember the news of a US border agency being hacked into. As a result, millions of traveler photos and license plates have been exposed. But it is not always about bad-intentioned people or hackers. It has been over a year now that GDPR has been put into effect, seriously restricting organizations' personal data processing initiatives. Since then, we've been hearing digital giants like Google, Facebook, even Spotify come under scrutiny for their suspicious data processing initiatives. We are still failing on the topic of digital resilience. Digital resilience is an organization's capability to maintain, change, and recover technology-dependent operational capabilities. These days, organizations are heavily investing in cyber defense products and services, but things are not going to get any easier. As technology evolves, so do cyber threats. It's now time to realize that privacy and cybersecurity are to be included from the beginning in the design phase of products, processes, and services. Doing so is called privacy by design or security by design. Today, most organizations see cybersecurity as the responsibility of the IT department and privacy as the responsibility of the legal or compliance department. Applying privacy by design means a cross-functional team that is composed of legal, IT, and product design elements actually take care of the privacy and cybersecurity implications of these new products, processes, and services. This way, we stop with the firefighting approach and switch to a more proactive approach when it comes to digital resilience.